Hello guys, I live in the Arctic part of Swedish Lapland, north of the Arctic Circle. A unique place with large areas with Bortle 1 and Bortle 2 night skies. We have also a long and dark polar winter, and during summertime the sun never sets, so we have midnight sun. And therefore the season for astrophotography is limited from early September until early April. With such a little light pollution, the starry sky could be breathtaking, but it also places special demands on the equipment and on the photographer. You have to cope with the cold and temperatures that could drop well below minus 30 or minus 40 degrees Celsius. I have been photographing for many years, and I have also a big interest in other outdoor activities such as hiking, biking, skiing and fly fishing. So these are my experiences, and we will begin to look at the equipment. I have been using the Skywatcher EQ6R Pro for 2 seasons, and I have not had any big problems at all. However, the synscan control does not really work at all in the cold. The display gets very lazy and unreadable. As I live north of the Arctic Circle, at about 66-67 degrees north, and the mount officially has a limit at 65 degrees, I lower the south leg on the tripod a few degrees, no big deal at all. My mount guides as a god, even through extended sessions in temperatures below minus 20 degrees Celsius. Some say that you can get problems with pinched stars when you use triplet refractors in a cold climate. I don't know, and have only used my doublet refractor, the Skywatcher EvoStar 80ED. When I bought it, I was recommended to buy a doublet for use in extreme cold. Therefore, I could not confirm problems with the triplet refractors when using them in cold climate. Maybe some of you guys out there knows more. Let me know then in the comment section below. But with that said, I have not experienced any problems at all with my doublet refractor. Of course, you need a dew heater to avoid frost on the lens, the same as you get on the car window when it's cold. I have to admit that I have fallen in love with the ASIR Pro. Last year I used a laptop, and it was hard to handle in the cold. I could not use it with my gloves, and it was hard to solve the power supply. Small problems get huge when you sit out in the dark and it's minus 20 degrees. The ASIR Pro has helped me a lot in handling in the cold. To control everything, I use a Samsung Galaxy tablet. It can run a whole night on its battery, very impressive. However, I used to bring a power bank just in case it runs low on battery, but so far I have not experienced any problem. I also use a small Wi-Fi router to extend its Wi-Fi range. This setup has made it more possible to focus on the photography instead of problem solving and cope with cold fingers. And to make things even more easy, I use the EAF focuser. After I've done an initial manual focus with a Batinov mask, I now only have to monitor the focus during the process. The autofocus functions seem to work flawless so far. Cables are a big concern, however. They get very stiff. For a power supply, I use silicone cables, and they are great. I have also secured the contacts with tape since I had an incident when the mount pulled out one of the cable from the contact when it slewed. I power everything up with a 12-volt 86 ampere hour marine battery. It does the job, and I have not had any problem. I can run the gear a whole night. I use this 2-to-1 split contact, one for a mount and the other for the ASIR Pro. First I used the Canon EOS 60D DSLR, but had some problems when I ran it with a supplied battery. If you use DSLR, it could probably be worth to power it with a cord from an external source. Recently I have bought the SVO ASI 2600 MC Pro, that one, which I power through the ASIR Pro and my marine battery. One advantage with the climate is that the camera does not use a lot of power for cooling. When I did the North American nebula a couple of days ago, it was minus 22, minus 23 degrees in the air, and I ran the sensor at minus 20 degrees. So far, no problem with the 2600 MC Pro, but I have only used it at two occasions. When I'm done with the shooting, I'm very careful with the cables. I don't roll them up directly. Instead, I put them down in a basket and roll them up when they have been warm and soft again. The most important link in the chain is the astrophotographer. If you can't handle the cold, the other does not matter. So it's very important to dress properly. The feet could get cold quickly. I use only wool socks, two or three layers, a thin compression sock as the innermost layer, then a little thicker wool sock, and if it's really cold I use an even thicker wool sock as the third layer. I use these touring boots from Swedish company Lundags. I have to wear gloves almost all time, so I use two pairs. First these thinner ones, and with this I can control the tablet with my pen, and then a pair of thicker and warmer ones. And when it's really cold, I use even these thumb gloves with wool inner mittens. And with these I can cope temperatures below minus 40 degrees. And you have to protect your head. A cap down to around 0 degrees, so it's a summer solution. A thin hat, a little thicker and windproof hat, or if it's mega cold, the fur hat. And when I dress in layers. I begin with merino wool as the innermost layer, then a thicker merino wool layer or a fleece layer, and last a down jacket. And this is my expedition grade down jacket that I used to bring, because when you stand still for 4, 5, 6 hours and waiting for a camera to shoot an object, you will get cold if it's minus 20, 25 degrees. It's also very important to adjust the clothing depending on the temperature and your activity. So when I come to a location, even if it's very cold, I don't need to put on the thickest down jacket and the thickest gloves and the fur hat directly. Because if I get sweaty, I will start to freeze quite too soon. It's also important to bring something to eat when you're out. If you get hungry, you will get cold easy. So bring some sandwiches and a thermos with some hot drink. And if you begin to feel cold anyway, jog around, jump around, do some exercises to keep up the warm in the body. One thing that I have not mentioned yet is the headlight. But when it's cold, it could run out of battery quite quick. So I use this one. A headlight with an external battery that I could keep inside my down jacket and keep warm. And this is a model from the brand Silva. So these insights are based on my experiences being an astrophotographer in this environment. Please give me your experiences in the comment section below. And if you want to follow my life as an astrophotographer in this Arctic environment, please subscribe to my channel.